Welcome to part two of Venn diagrams and set operations. In this video, we'll take a look at a couple of examples to reinforce the ideas introduced in part one. So we first want to be able to create a Venn diagram to show the relationship among the sets, where the universal set U is a set of whole numbers from 1 to 15, A is a set of multiples of 3, B is a set of primes, and C is a set of odd numbers. So the universal set is going to be contained within a rectangle, so let's go ahead and sketch that. Now I think it's going to be helpful if we go ahead and list all the elements of the universal set. Now let's go ahead and list the elements from the universal set that would be a member of set A. Well, set A consists of the multiples of 3, so we'd have 3, 6, 9, 12, and 15. Set B is a set of primes. Remember, a prime number has only two factors, but it has to be greater than 1. So we'd have 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, and 13. And then set C consists of the odd numbers from this list. So we'd have 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, and 15. So because we have three sets within the universal set, we have to have three circles in our Venn diagram. But before we sketch those three circles, let's take a look at the elements that these sets have in common. Notice that the number 3 is a member of all three sets, which tells us that all three circles will have to overlap and have a common region containing the element 3. So let's sketch our circles to look like this. And the region, and the 3 would be in the region where all three circles overlap, or in this region here. Now let's go ahead and label this set A, this will be set B, and this will be set C. Let's focus on the placement of the elements in set A. Notice other than 3, A and B do not have any common elements, but A and C do have elements in common. They both contain 9, and they both contain 15. So 9 and 15 must occur where A and C overlap. So there'd be a 9 in this region here, as well as a 15. And the remaining elements in set A would be in this region here. So we have a 6 and a 12 that are in set A, but not in set B or set C. Now let's see if we can place the elements in set B in the correct regions. Notice that sets B and set C do share common elements. They both contain 5, 7, 11, and 13. So these four elements must occur where sets B and C overlap, which would be in this region here. So we have 5, 7, 11, and 13. There's only one other element that is in set B, and that would be the element 2, so there must be a 2 in this region here. And now we're left to take a look at set C. All the elements in set C have been accounted for except for the element 1, so there must be a 1 here. Now the last thing we have to do is make sure that we have accounted for every element in the universal set. And since C contains all of the odd elements of the universal set, let's just go ahead and check the even elements. The number 2 is in set B. Number 2 is in set B. Number 4 is not in any of these sets, but it's in the universal set, so we'll have to list it here. 6 is a multiple of 3. 8 has not been listed. 10 has not been listed. 12 is a multiple of 3. 14 has not been listed. And now we have all the elements in the universal set listed and how they relate to sets A, B, and C. Now let's take a look at our second example. Here we have the following Venn diagram. We want to determine each of the following sets. So our first set is A intersected with B. This would contain the elements that are in both set A and set B in this region here. So it would contain the elements 6 and 7. Number 2 is A union B. That would be all the elements that are in A or in B. So we'd have 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10, 17, and 19. It would be all the elements in this entire region here. On number three, we want the complement of A union B. That's going to be all the elements in the universal set that are not in the union of A and B. Well, this is the region of A union B, so all the elements not in this region would be 20 and 21. Now for the last two, we have the complement of A intersected with B. Well, the complement of A would be all the elements that are not in set A. Let's go ahead and shade that region. This would be all of the elements that are not in set A. That's the complement of A. We want to intersect this with set B. Well, here's set B. We want to know what elements are in both the yellow set and the blue set. And when we did that, it turned green. So it would be the elements 4, 5, and 6 are the elements that are in both the complement of A and set B. Let's go ahead and try one more of those. We want A union the complement of B. So here's set A. And now we want to shade the complement of B, so we want to shade all the elements that are not in set B. So it would be these elements here and these elements here. So if the complement of B is the yellow region, A is the blue region, and we want the union of those two sets. So we want all of the elements that have been shaded by yellow or by blue. So the only elements that would not be in this union would be the elements that have not been shaded, or 2, 4, and 5. So we'll include 6, 7, 9, 10, 17, 19, as well as 20 and 21. I want to finish by showing you this Venn diagram here. You may want to pause the video and see if you can make sense of this. It shows a notation that can be used for the intersection of three sets within a universal set. I just want to make a quick comment on the notation used here. A superscript C is another way to denote the complement of A. So B superscript C would be the complement of B, and C superscript C would be the complement of C. I hope you found these examples helpful. Thank you for watching.